welcome to the Platinum Jubilee celebration, a very special night here in the grounds of Windsor Castle. Celebrating the reign of Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, ahead of you tonight is a performance filled with theatrical pageantry that will take you on a gallop through history. Please be aware that tonight's performance will include flashing lights and pyrotechnics. Our special guests will be joining us shortly, but before that, we hope you will enjoy our pre-show, led by the fantastic Tri-Service Orchestra. And to begin, please welcome to the arena the Corps of Drums of the Band of Her Majesty's Royal Marines. Thank you.
up will form two ranks. Form two ranks! In open order. In the dress! Guard of Honor will move to the left in threes. For threes! Left! Guard of Honor! By the right! Quick! Thank you.
welcome your host, Adam Chisholm.
First, Queen of England, Wales, and our commitment to her subjects. Literature, arts, military prowess, trade, science, and exploration were the foundation stones that made these tiny islands great. And it was all as a result of this remarkable woman's leadership. Surrounded by able people, including privateers such as Drake and Hawkins, playwrights like Shakespeare and Marlowe, explorers including Raleigh, statesmen like Cecil and Walsingham, the hero of our story was supported. It was truly a golden age.
It was busy playing bowls, which was basically cricket before anyone had any idea how to use a bat. A bit like the England cricket team today. I think I might be in with a chance of winning this match.
Don't be ridiculous. I've never lost to you and I never will.
Is that the Spanish fleet?
Stop trying to put me off.
I'm not. I'm serious. The Spanish are attacking.
Oh, leave off. You'll be claiming ponies are invading the pitch next.
Ships scattering their fleet with our pyrotechnics. We never wanted this. The Spanish came here to give us hell, and by George, we've given them hell back and hell! Yes! Yes! Come on!
Fantastic. During this time, Queen Elizabeth I stood fast with her subjects. as the damaged armada approached the east coast of England, the Queen prepared to face the invading Spanish army with 4,500 troops at Tilbury. She made what is now considered to be one of the most inspiring and motivating calls to arms ever to be spoken by a monarch.
Let tyrants fear. I have always so behaved myself that under God I have placed my chiefest strength and safeguard in the loyal hearts and goodwill of my subjects. Therefore, I have come amongst you, as you see at this time, not for my recreation and disport, but in the midst and heat of the battle, to live and die amongst you all, to lie down for my God, and for my kingdom, and my people, my honor, and my blood, even in the dust. I know I have the body of a weak and feeble woman, but I have the heart and stomach of a king, and of a king of England.
Greatest adversaries, Pope Sixtus V.
She is only a woman, only the mistress of half an island, and yet she makes herself feared by Spain, by France, by the Empire, by all.
Ascended to the throne, and in the Act of Union, four nations, England, Ireland, Scotland, and Wales, became one under King James I.
The reign of James I was beset with troubles. The notorious gunpowder plot was just one of them, when Guy Fawkes tried to blow up Parliament, a famous British failure still celebrated to this day. From other countries, failure is a cause of national disgrace. For the British, it's an excuse for a party!
Just when the nation believed itself to be stable, the English Civil War resulted in the call for the return of its joyous culture and tradition. 21 years after his father's demise, Charles II rode into England and a new society was born.
After puritanical Britain, we really arrived at cool Britannia. As Charles the First ended in tragedy, so Charles the Second began in triumph. We've had enough of the rotten roundheads. We're now ready for the royal rock and roll. And though it wasn't time yet to uncork the corgis, we had a healthy sprinkling of spaniels. Yeah. Look at those gorgeous dogs. Creating the glorious gold uniforms of the household cavalry.
Performing in uniforms reminiscent of Louis XIV's times, please welcome the elegance of La Maison du Roi, the House of the King.
Thank you.
Captain Franco and Captain Bligh in their ships, discovering the Northwest Passage, Australasia, and Polynesia.
England confides that every man will do his duty. You must be quick, for I have one more signal to make, which is for close action.
Aye, aye, sir.
And then there were the sheer, barking mad British explorers who'd spent so much time in the sun, they longed for cooler climes.
First man to travel to the North Pole in a motorized vehicle. Why? The way the sun shines on yonder glaciers, the snow almost seems like sand.
I think it is sand, Paddington.
Is it, Billington?
Might explain that gentleman over there.
By Jove, is that Lawrence of Arabia?
Judging by the themes, I'd say it was.
You know, I knew you were wrong, Turning, in a few seconds.
I told you not to rely on the sand now.
The sounds and smells of the Middle East. The fragrance of frankincense from Oman, which will fill our arena here tonight. The campfire singing under an endless cloak of stars fills me with delight.
We have many friends in the Middle East, including Bahrain. And the United Kingdom has been an ally, a partner, and a friend to the Sultanate of Oman for hundreds of years. In traditional dress, please welcome the Royal Cavalry of Oman.
Black business. Black business.
the British Museum, because competitors are required to sweep up after themselves during the event. And of course, there were our polar explorers, including Shackleton, Sir Edmund Hillary, and Scott's ill-fated expedition to Antarctica in 1930.
On reaching the South Pole, we discovered that we'd been beaten by the Norwegian, Roald Amundsen. On our return, our enemy has been the weather. A blizzard has kept us in our tent for more than a week, only 10 miles from our supplies. We shall stick it out to the end, but we are getting weaker, of course, and the end cannot be far. For God's sake, look after our people.
A tale of heroism, both English and Norwegian. By the way, Scott, I love your outfit. You look very cool.
Cool? Cool? I'm absolutely freezing.
King Harald V of Norway, a second cousin to Her Majesty the Queen. Please welcome the Majesty the King's Guard Band and Drill Team.
Circumstances. One, a correspondent of the New York Herald, and the other, a Scottish physician who had been missing for 6 years. They greeted each other in a way that only those from the Victorian era could. Dr. Livingstone, I presume?
That is correct.
But what have you been doing in Africa for the last 6 years?
All that I can say is, never buy a timeshare from Lorraine Kelly.
Wise words. Livingston and others like Darwin.
The Silk Route to China. On the way there is a colourful and proud country, known around the globe as the Land of Fire. Please welcome the dancers, musicians, riders and horses from the Republic of Azerbaijan.
my idea to put itching powder on their saddles and in their trousers. One more time for the Azerbaijani and Kostya!
Well, never know where the kiffin is now, but it smells better.
Yes, I'm terribly sorry, Barrington. Here we go again.
Oh, apology gradually accepted, sir.
The Commonwealth is an enduring theme of the Queen's reign. It's unique and demonstrates the power of forgiveness for troubles past and the common history that we all share, showing that what unites us is stronger than what divides us. Members of the Commonwealth are represented here tonight, and to lead us in our celebration, we welcome a country celebrating 75 years of independence from the United Kingdom. Please welcome the Bollywood Co. featuring Jazz Army and Priti Basani.
Yeah.
drum call.
Thank you.
Birkinshire horses. The Windsor Greys, Icon, and Newark, tonight relieved from carriage duty. Representing Ireland, the Irish Draft, with two Household Cavalry State Trumpeters. The Connemara, Lady Louise's riding pony, Dunrig and Marty. Next, Tuesa, a purebred Arabian stallion gifted to Her Majesty by His Majesty the King of Bahrain. To Scotland and the Highlands, three working ponies from the Balmoral Estate. Next, two fell ponies representing England, recently pictured with Her Majesty, Bybeck Katie and Bybeck Nightingale. And from Wales, Starlight, a children's riding pony.
Celebration, and as we say goodbye to so many horses and ponies that give Her Majesty so much joy, we welcome the cast that's been so pleased to be here in this great event.
Thank you.